Health Assembly, where we today experience a historical moment because we, for the first time ever, delivered a statement in front of the governments at the WHO. This makes me really proud, as now we are a global voice for effective alcohol policies in the United Nations.
The presence of the alcohol industry at the Montevideo Conference was deeply troubling and led to the omission of alcohol taxation from the Montevideo Roadmap. I thank you for your attention.
Main advocacy concerns this week were non-communicable diseases and tuberculosis, and we were making sure that governments understand the potential of alcohol policies in reducing these diseases, as alcohol is a risk factor to both non-communicable diseases, as cancer, for example, lung diseases, and of course tuberculosis, an infectious disease. And to bring these topics together and show the potential of alcohol policies, we arranged a side event where four different countries were talking about how they use alcohol policies to improve people's health. So, for example, Botswana was talking about alcohol policy and how it contributes to the eradication of tuberculosis, and Estonia was talking about alcohol policies and how they contribute to the decrease of non-communicable diseases, and Thailand was talking about alcohol policies and how they contribute to the health for all. This week we have been working to bring together countries that want to make alcohol harm and alcohol policy solutions the priority it should be. And at the same time, we were supporting them with the expertise from our members from all over the world.